for sale is my 1946 J.A.P Model 5. Really beautiful engine, this one. Finished restoring this about a month ago. I had a full nut and bolt stripped down restoration. Everything was taken completely to bits, cleaned up. Crankcase has been fully cleaned out, fresh oil, everything cleaned up. Carburetor was gone through, that's been cleaned out. And there are a number of faults with the car which have been rectified. Now, this is an industrial engine, J.A.P industrial engine, and they usually run far too fast. So what I've actually done here is just set the gear and everything and then lock the butterfly off. It's locked off at just enough speed that it can run a reasonable load on the pulley there all day long, and that won't slow it down too much. You'll see it runs really smartly. The jet has been set up with the engine hot, so it runs quite lean. So as a result, it's very, very economical. I think it used probably about a quarter of a tank, an afternoon's rally. It's just got stub exhaust, but it's actually pretty quiet. Very handy oil drain there. Magneto, that's in really good condition. Barrel, that's been painted with high temperature black paint. It's decarbonised. I built a trolley for it. It's got brand new cast iron wheels on it. No play in the bearings. No lift, no back and forwards. It's in really, really good shape, and the big end particularly looked fantastic. I've never seen one quite so good. Non-leaking tap, very nice seal there. The cork was repaired. You soak them in petrol and they swell up again, so this one doesn't leak. Nice fresh oil in there. You can see the date stamp there, 1946. So yeah, all in all, very nice engine. So I'll start it up now. This engine is more unusual in that it's rope start. It's normally handle start. As this was set up when hot, you have to open the choke slowly, let it warm up. So here goes. There we are. It hasn't been started for a few weeks, so just being a little petty there. So as you can see, needs a lot of choke to start. Fired first pull is always a good sign. Sometimes start first pull as well. Just warming up a little. So. But, no oil leaks or anything. The pulley there does have a chip, but you could cut the end off, I suppose. So I'll just let it warm up for a minute. So you can hear, no nasty knocks. Breather there works very well. Flywheel runs true. Fuel tank's in good condition. Nice long reach plug in there. We've got two spokes missing under cowling there, but you could probably repair that if you wanted. There we are. Now she's warmed up. She'll run with the choke open. And once she's warmed up a bit more, it runs even better. Nice lightweight engine, weighs about 60 kilograms, which is sort of half the weight of your average engine like this. Really easy to move about. Again, with this one, I've got plenty of photos of the restoration if you want to see those. If you're interested in buying, you know, let me know and I can email you pictures. She's warmed up now, so speed it up. Like I said, it was set to run just a little fast, so that once it's loaded, running a little pump or something, it just slows down to a good speed. So for this engine, I'm looking for 60 pounds. I think is very fair. You won't find another in this condition or that runs as well. It's got to be collection only from Kent. Too heavy to post. But as you can see, runs beautiful, looks beautiful, and I think a bargain, 60 quid, and you won't get another restored ready to rally engine like this for that kind of money. Been rallied a couple of times, had some very very positive comments, and she ran all day, very economical. So there we are, no nasty knocks. Runs really smooth, looks good, and £60, and it's yours. So if you're interested, send me a PM, and you know, let me know. Okay, thanks for watching.